Okay, today let's talk a little bit about the origin of tissues, more specifically the ectoderm, mesoderm, and endoderm. All right, let's first back up a little bit, and we'll start with the zygote, and this is after fertilization right here. And what happens is the zygote will multiply, and then multiply again. But the most important thing to get out of this is that it just multiplies, it doesn't grow. So the exact size of it is still the same, but it's multiplying just in number, just to kind of to create surface area. So this ball here, that's called the blastula. And this ball here is called the gastrula. And then the third one will be the morula. And the easy way to remember that is the alphabet. Blastula, B, becomes before G, which comes before M. So blastula, gastrula, morula. Okay, in gastrulation, you can see that there's kind of a pouch here, like a pouch. And this actual inner pouch is called the archanteron. The outside here is called the ectoderm, and then the inside will be the endoderm. Now, these three terms, I'm sure you've seen them many, many times. But, the ectoderm, it actually derives into a lot of different things, like the eyes and those kind of things. But the most general term that you can use to probably help you memorize this is outer cover. Ecto meaning outer. So anything that's kind of on the outside, like the eyes, those kind of things. Mesoderm, I like to think muscles. Muscles are kind of in the middle, organs, these kind of things. And the endoderm, we typically think of the digestive system.